In November 1441, the streets of London witnessed a scene reminiscent of Cersei Lannister's Walk of Shame on Game of Thrones, though with less nudity. Eleanor, Duchess of Gloucester, walked barefoot through the filthy city carrying a candle in an act of public penance for the crime of witchcraft. But the crime Eleanor was really guilty of was being married to a powerful man with just as powerful enemies. From the time of their marriage in 1428, she'd been unpopular. Humphrey, Duke of Gloucester, had his marriage to wife Jacqueline proved invalid in order to marry the famous beauty Eleanor, who, however, was from a solidly gentry background rather than from the nobility. So she was widely viewed as ambitious and grasping, and her interest in magic must have seemed like a perfect target for her courtly enemies. In the 15th century, it was very common and respectable for men and women to show an interest in astrology. So there was nothing unusual in Eleanor consulting professional astrologers. It was a perfectly respectable profession at the time. The problem came when she was accused of having those astrologers cast a forecast of the king's death. Such an act was treasonous. Eleanor denied these charges, but admitted purchasing a potion from a London witch in order to conceive a child by her husband. Eleanor's supposed conspirators were executed, but Eleanor escaped with a pardon. However, she spent the rest of her life essentially under house arrest, probably in order to have a hold over her husband, Duke Humphrey, who was seen as a threat to the throne. We can learn a lot from this case about magic, gender, and politics in the later Middle Ages. Magic was more respectable than you'd think, but when used by women, it could still be weaponized against them. In the Game of Thrones that was the Wars of the Roses, it was very easy to lose your throw of the dice. Happy Halloween.